Hello, Jeff, Joelle, and friends. Hope y'all are having a wonderful day. Let's rock this podcast.
Yeah, wow, a lot of love. Sharing a lot of love.
Love it.
Nice. I just got the urge for chocolate, just to let you know, just like right now.
Man, those ones I got, they're vegan. Yeah, they're vegan. So, and they're gluten-free. Okay. They're dairy-free.
We'll stop talking about it. Next. Hey, we're live. How's everybody going? How's everybody doing?
Stopping by to give thanks. Continuing education for dog owners and trainers is mandatory. Grateful.
Awesome. Dogs just stop doing bad shit. It's incredible. And then you get to start training your dog. Hey, everybody. How are you? It's Jeff Gellman, Sally Canine Training. This is Joelle, and this is the What Would Jeff Do show. Happy Monday to everybody. Hope everyone's doing great outside, great inside, great wherever you are around the world. We've got a worldwide audience. It's really, really exciting. So this is a Q&A show. You ask questions. Joelle reads the questions. I give the answer. If you've never seen the show before, it's semi-unprofessional to the bordering on inappropriate. And then we have a seminar series called Jeff Gellman Seminars, Jeff Gellman Seminars. And right now they're on hold, obviously, because we're not going anywhere. But we're rearranging this year's schedule. We'll probably be doing seminars. We'll probably pick up probably the last 4 months of the year, probably the last third of the year.
Yeah.
And then the 2021 schedule, we're going to start actually putting out. Probably that's my project for this week, is to start planning for 2021.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Yep. So for the dates for 2021, started planning that. And Joelle launched a brand new Patreon channel. That's really, really exciting. Super proud of you. Patreon.com, Joelle Gifford. So you can check that out for all your workouts and your macro planning. If you know what macro planning is, it's probably one of the best things in the world as far as eating healthy, because you can eat a lot of stuff that you wouldn't think you couldn't eat. Yes, you can. That's obvious. I saw the tractor trailer pull up today. So
is it sad that I've had Amazon delivering my chocolate bars because I don't want to go to stores?
Yeah, but every time I go out to a store, I buy one or two.
True.
So, yeah.
Does anyone else have chocolate delivered?
I bought two today. Did you notice?
And then three came in today. Yeah. So nice. We have five chocolate bars.
Great. Awesome. So tomorrow we'll have three. All right. These are big-ass chocolate bars, too. All right, everybody. Dark chocolate, by the way. Not milk chocolate. And then we have the training center, which is where we're doing the show from. And the training center, it's, you know, we talk about punishment a lot on this show because a lot of people ask us how to stop things. The training center, it's you know, mostly reward-based training, because we're, especially for obedience. But not too many people on this show are going to ask me about obedience. They're going to ask me on how to stop a behavior. So I use the word punishment. It's important that people understand that punishment, you're not yelling, you're not screaming, you're not mad, you're not upset. It's just matter of fact. Stop it. Like, we've got a couple of crate breakers here. We'll probably share the experience. You know, what I want to do? I want to give a little tour of Ranger's crate, like what we've done and then how we solve the problem. I think we should show Ranger's crate, how we've reinforced it, the camera setup, the monitor in my room, and the remote on the dog, and literally what we do.
Yeah, still alive.
And little what
do
we do.
Live
give
on
give
it.
People a little tour.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we should do that and explain, because everyone could be doing that at home. That could be a home setup, a very practical home setup. So zip ties, Amazon has that nanny cam for $79, because I bought two cords for it today. So now we've got two working cameras, two working screens. All right. So let's just jump right in. There's something called Top Chat, and that's at the bottom. A lot of people have been doing a lot of Top Chats. Number one, to thank us for all the great stuff that we've been giving away for 15 years. And then also, your question does get to the top of the queue, but you do not have to pay to play. As you'll find out, we will go through as many questions as possible in the next hour. It's a 7 to 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time show, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And let's go.
All right. Melissa, good evening, Jeff, Joelle, and everyone in the chat.
Oh, hey. Hey, Melissa. How are you?
Hello.
Love you.
Hello, Gretchen. Hi, guys. I had a productive day. Now I'm trying to not fall asleep. LOL. How are you? Weather got nice again.
Good. Awesome. Things are good. Try not to fall asleep. But, yeah, I put people to sleep sometimes. Next.
Cheryl. Hi, Jeff and Joelle. Hope you and everyone in the chat had a great weekend and are optimistically looking forward to a wonderful week.
Yeah. I mean, every day. We really don't have weekends here.
No.
No, we sort of just have, like,
I don't even know what the days are.
We just have days. And they all end in Y, you know? So it's just like every day seems to run into every other day here. So, next.
Kathy, hi all. Yucky, rainy day. Not the sun. not the sun is out, but it's too wet to take the dogs out. They think it's okay. I know better. Had a nap.
Yeah, they think it's okay.
A nap sounds great.
Get yourself some of them boots, them big boots, the just literally rain boots.
Yeah.
They look like riding boots, but they're made for like really wet, wet, like mucking boots.
Mucks.
Yeah, mucks. And you just get those and like, dogs don't give a shit. Next.
Mothman, hello, Jeff, Joelle, and friends. Hope y'all are having a wonderful day. Let's rock this podcast.
Yeah, wow, a lot of love. Sharing a lot of love.
Love it.
Nice. I just got the urge for chocolate, just to let you know, just like right now.
Man, those ones I got, they're vegan. Yeah, they're vegan. So, and they're gluten-free. They're dairy-free.
We'll stop talking about it. Next.
Barista boy, beautiful today. Supposed to snow tomorrow.
Nice.
E-collar came and can't be happier. Quality. What order should prong and e-collar be in, LOL?
We like the prong collar up top and the e-collar down below. The reason why is because the prong collar is going to give you some more directional control. E-collars are not directional. Next.
Gretchen, Joelle, you're always so pretty.
Yep.
Oh, thanks, Gretchen.
Every day. Next.
Michelle Anderson, good evening, Jeff and Joelle.
Hey, Michelle, how are you from Calgary?
Urban Canine Dog Services, just wanted to let you know how much I've enjoyed the couch conversations. Brittany does such a great job of explaining, and Joelle's questions and further explanations are awesome.
Yes, the ladies are doing fantastic with it, and if you've not seen the couch conversations, we've put up three. We'll be making another one this week on NCS, and which is non-compliance stim. And then there's another one I wanted to do, but I know we have the non-compliance stim to do. I mentioned it.
Shoot, what was it?
I mentioned it on the last show. Maybe someone remembers. Next.
Steven, just got a fearful 3-year-old female who doesn't accept food, toys, or physical affection.
Yep.
Even cowers when given verbal praise.
Yep.
How do I get her out of the perpetual fear so we can begin working on obedience?
So believe it or not, put a leash on the dog. Remote cower is going to be your best friend. And that goes against what most people think. So I've got this fearful dog and now I'm shocking it. It's like, that's one way to put it. But a remote collar will help unleash the dog. It'll help unlock the dog's brain. We see it all the time. This is the kind of dog that you're probably going to have to use some compulsion with. Compulsion meaning force. It's like put a leash on the dog, prong collar on the dog, and just let's go. Work the dog through everything. We get dogs that don't take food. Okay, well then, you know, you got to work the dog. You still got to work the dog. You still got to get your reps in. Some people will say, well, wait till you build a relationship. Well, if it's a client, there's no time, or we don't have the time, or the client doesn't have the budget until that relationship is built. Or if it's your own personal dog, it's like, I don't want to wait 6 months to a year to start. Let me start now. And you can actually start today. So start working the dog. Mm-hmm. Start working the dog. Next. At a minimum, walk the dog around a room. Next.
Pulsar dog training. My boyfriend, his cousin, and I did our own pack walk with our dogs. My dog whines and tried to forge ahead the whole time. She knows heel, and I try to correct with prong and e-collar. 180s work temporarily.
So what you need to do is you need to get that dog into follow mode. Watch my spatial pressure video. Also, a lot of times, it's common when the other dogs are in front, your dog wants to get up to them. So what you can do is you can do a bunch of quick 180s, real 180s, not just like moving 180. If you watch my 180 video, which it sounds like you did, those work tremendously. And then also what you can do is without the other dogs, just start becoming more valuable to your dogs. That's it. Just become more valuable. But that dogs, it's a very common issue where dogs will forge ahead, especially when other dogs are ahead of them. Next.
My dog is smart and well-behaved. Our dog won't let us put the prong collar on her. What should we do?
Well, your dog is being smart and well-behaved, obviously, have nothing to do with it. So, you know,
no, that's their name. Our dog is smart and well-behaved. Like, that's their YouTube handle.
Oh. Then that has a lot to do with it, because you're asking the question. So, what's the question?
Question is...
Because people usually say that. Your dog is smart.
I know. Well, that's their handle. The question is, our dog won't let us put the prong collar on her. What should we do?
So a lot of people will say it's because the prong collar hurts. No, it's because the dog just doesn't want you to put the prong collar on. I've had dogs that don't want to take a prong collar off. Well, if it hurts so much, why can't I take it off? Mm-hmm. You know, they won't let me take the shock collar off. Well, if it hurts so much, why can't I take it off? Why can't I put a slip lead on a dog? Why can't I put a martingale on a dog? Some dogs just don't like hands going towards the neck. They don't like that type of pressure. That is a pressure source. You moving towards a dog, your hands going towards a dog's head is a pressure source. That's why people get bit on their hands. It's like I was just trying to pet the dog like that fool yesterday was on Blackstone Boulevard. It's like you're not the brightest bulb. No. So what you want to do is you want to watch my Rupert collar conditioning video, Rupert's collar conditioning, and it's going to be done with a food and a clicker, and that dog is going to fall in love with the prong. Next.
Barista boy, I've seen some hate, and these people scare me, like, make me uncomfortable.
Where?
I don't know.
Oh, well, yeah, just on social media? Mm-hmm. Yeah, the hate's still there. Hate won't go away because people have hate in their hearts, so... You know, we still get it. We don't get as much of it. Once the seminars start, we'll probably it'll ramp up again. You know, the thing is that I mentioned this before. I think I've done a bunch of little lives about a reset. You know, using this time to reset and work on yourself and work on your personal growth. And I have a lot of empathy for people that are hateful. Mm. It's like you must be in so much. See, hate is a mirror. It is a mirror. So what you're projecting is actually what's within. So you actually don't hate me, you hate yourself. You're talking to yourself. So when you send me something, you're really talking to yourself. So just replace Jeff with your name. So I have empathy for those people. They're in a lot of pain. And the cool part about that is that it's like your hate for me has nothing to do with me. But the cool part about that is you can actually become better. You can actually become a better person, but it's painful and it's hard. And there's hate comes from all different ways. Hate comes from, you know, all different reasons why. And it goes towards people that are doing well, that are doing successful. They want to knock you down. It comes from jealousy, whether it's on someone's looks. It's a lot of it. It shows a lot of insecurity. Plus, it's also just really mean to do.
Mm.
It's just really mean,
yeah.
You know, and it's just ironic that like somebody would get upset about their kids being bullied in school, but meanwhile they're online bullying other people.
Mm-hmm.
It's like set an example. Where do you think right. It came from? Your apple does not fall far from the tree. Next,
Levi. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Hope everyone is well.
Yeah, things are fantastic.
Urban Canine Dog Services. P.S. Is Toronto still on the books at this point?
Nothing has happened as far as not doing Toronto as long as we can get into Canada. So we're taking it right now. I'm not making any decision on April and May. Things have been rescheduled. June, I have not made any decisions on June yet. I'm not sure when Toronto is, but June is the next month I have to make a decision on. And I'm going to wait until probably the first week of May to see where things stand, you know, on that. Next.
Michelle, congrats on Patreon, Joelle. Thanks, yep. Michelle.
Yep.
Pulsar dog training. She's not really dog reactive. I walk her with another dog and pass multiple dogs a day without this happening. We were walking in a place she had never been. Dogs do not meet and sit quietly together.
Right. Now, what you want to do is walk that dog alone, and then you're going to see the real dog. So usually a dog that walks in a pack is on better behavior. Sometimes
she only does this during pack walks, though, the forging.
Oh, the forging ahead. Oh, she wants to be first. Yeah, so you can do a couple of things like a heel tap to the chest. No, I'm not telling you to kick your dog. It's a heel tap. It's like if you ride horses, you also use your feet on a horse, and you're not kicking the horse. Heel tap to the chest. Teach that dog remote collar heel. Teach that dog watch my spatial awareness, spatial pressure video. Next.
Pack leader dog training. Hey, Jeff and Joelle. Good to be here.
Hey, great to have you here.
Melissa posted the link to my Patreon channel.
Thank you, Melissa. You can do that a couple of times during the show, please.
Levi, your social videos are awesome. I think my oldest would make bad decisions in a situation like that. How do we get to the point where he makes better choices? Is it just controlled exposure to safe dogs and counter conditioning?
So what it is it's flooding with guidance. And absolutely, it's with you advocating for your dog. You advocating for your dog, but also knowing what dogs are around you. That's what we're talking about, socialization, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's about you advocating for your dog and knowing what dogs are around you, which is really, really important.
Mm-hmm.
And getting your dog to be around lots of dogs, not necessarily interacting with them, is like going to be the first step. Next.
Michelle P. Dark chocolate is everything.
It is.
Agreed.
Yes.
Super cheeses. Used a prong collar on my 6-month-old Bernedoodle today. What a game changer. Thanks for all the tips and videos. Can't wait until he has leash reactivity to see how he does.
So this is the cool thing about prongs, is it's a tool that communicates to the dog. Don't forget about the training part. So what I want you to do is still do the training, still work the dog. Next.
Levi, what is your approach to treadmill training a new dog? Ever use a prong collar for it?
We only use prong collars for it. It's the safest thing to do. Mm-hmm. And people would think, oh my God, no, it's going to hurt the dog. No, it won't. Every other collar is going to actually choke the dog. And a harness is impractical. It's going to probably spin the dog around. So I've got videos on, I've got two or three videos on how to teach the, a treadmill. Next.
Holding on dog training. Good evening, J&J. Hope all is well. Thanks for keeping us in some sort of reality. Couldn't wait for 7 o'clock. Love
you. Thank you, Ashley. And 8:30 tonight, you fuck your husband, so that'll be a good time.
Oh, my and God.
That's the time. It's 8:30 on Mondays. That's the once
How
a week.
How do you know this?
Because I talked to her. Ashley, I'm going to actually call you tomorrow. Number one, I want a full report. Number two, let's talk about planning the February 2021 seminar. Next.
Woo, Levi, for socializing and boundaries with an existing dog and a new dog, would you ever set it up so the existing dog corrects the new dog or not let it get there by limiting control over the new dog? I feel like a dog-to-dog correcting is more clear than I could correct, but I worry of overcorrecting from the existing dog.
I was just going to say, all depends if your other dog knows how to properly, responsibly correct that other dog. And then also, the new dog, which is a puppy, I guess, so that wouldn't be... Ideally, if you've got a good puppy raiser, that would be perfect. But what happens when you don't? You end up with a hurt dog. Or the dog that overcorrects. So you have to be careful. And say hello to your lovely wife. Next.
Michelle, is there any prerequisite work I should be doing with the new e-collar before I apply it as a punisher? Should they wear it for a while before I use it?
Some folks will say yes. I say just start using it because we're using it. If you're using it for obedience, it's always on low level. You're not correcting your dog for that. But you can use it to correct your dog right out of the bat. I mean, if you want to buy a remote collar just to stop getting in the trash can, just to stop, fence fighting, just to stop jumping over a fence, just to stop barking in a car, just to stop barking in general, just to stop separation. I point over there to the universal separation anxiety section, to separation anxiety. You can. So, because it's not fair to an owner to say, well, you have to wait 2 weeks. It's mm-hmm. like, well, my landlord is going to kick me out in 24 hours, so I need to stop this today.
Right.
Or my dog is breaking out of the crate, I need to fix this now. Mm-hmm. Or my neighbor is like going to, shoot my dog if it keeps jumping over the fence. So, or I'm going to end up in the ER if my dog keeps getting in the trash or counter surfing. So, we don't, but you can. Next.
AL, we found you guys about a month ago. Thank you. Good behavior equals reward. Bad behavior equals punish.
Yeah, pretty simple concepts. Pretty fucking simple. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Pretty fucking simple.
PFS.
This dog training thing.
Hashtag PFS.
Yes, right.
Pretty fucking simple.
That's right.
Dropping F-bombs on this show.
Am I? Huh. Looks like I
like it.
Looks like I've gained some followers. Next.
It's always welcome in my world.
That's right.
LC, hey, I've used zip ties to reinforce my crate for my Roddy and an old iPod for a camera.
Yep. We use lots of zip ties. Zip tie the fuck out of it. Zip ties and carabiners and a nanny cam.
Literally so many carabiners.
Yep. So many zip ties.
Zip ties too.
Yeah.
But
yeah. Next.
Levi, I'm so happy with how my oldest dog's reactivity has come down while on walk. One preemptive e-collar correction and I get in between him and anyone's dogs.
Awesome job. Good for you for advocating. Next.
Edwin, hey Jeff. I practice heel with my 6-month-old GSP with e-collar. When cars go by, specifically trucks, she gets scared and loses focus. Is it fair to correct, or how do you manage that with the e-collar? Thank you.
Yeah, you can actually correct. You can actually correct. I mean, if you want to give a little bit of space, you can do that. The thing is you're not going to turn that into a positive experience right now because the dog is in a fear state. So what do? You're correcting not the fearfulness. You're correcting the dog's lack of proper positioning, which is the heel position. That's what you're doing. It's like, yeah, I know a truck's going by. So what I would do is I would work on it and then do the best you can and then go hunting for trucks. Next.
$24.99 from Michelle P. Cool plug and play. Also showing some love.
Oh, awesome.
Thank
you so much, Michelle. That's really nice of you.
Hater Slayer, howdy, y'all.
Hey, Hater Slayer, howdy to you.
OK, KK. Hi guys, fairly new dog, rarely wags her tail. Got a laser and her tail was crazy though. Am I actually doing good at keeping her arousal low, or are some dogs just like that?
You got a laser, as in laser, like the game for laser. I would encourage you highly not to do that. You'll end up with a neurotic dog. Now, I've seen dogs do scent work with laser. Like they'll point the laser at an area and the dog will go out and look for the odor there. Military uses that for a lot of their bomb sniffing dogs. But as far as laser, like on the ground, and so the dog like chases it, you're going to end up with a dog that literally will be neurotic.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen it a lot. Mm-hmm. In fact, sometimes dogs come in and I'm like, by its behavior, I'll say, do you play with this dog with a laser? They're like, yeah, how did you know? I'm like, because I can tell.
Yeah, they're always looking around, like searching for shit.
And then shadows freak them out, and any little pinpoint of light, and oh, they can go nuts.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine a dog, like, constantly wanting to catch a fly.
What? So, literally, Wes used to chase air particles, like, particles in the air. You know, when the sun comes through a
yes,
window?
Yes, you can see everything.
He'd chase them.
Yes.
I corrected it with an e-collar.
Yeah.
He was neurotic, literally.
Yeah. An article chasing...
like, dust in the air.
Right.
He'd be like...
You had dust in your house? Really?
With two dogs.
I'm surprised.
I know. I mean, it's pretty meticulous.
Yeah, I know. Jeez.
You can't avoid it all.
Dust.
Hater Slayer said, howdy, y'all.
You read that one already.
Oh, shit.
Howdy again.
Howdy again. Are you from Texas? Levi. He'll still whine, but such good progress. Would you correct Excellent. The whining or reward for when he looks or moves away?
Yes. Next.
Yes. Pulsar dog training. What usually goes first? The e-collar receiver or the remote? Considering if I should buy a whole new set or just get another collar. I already have both.
Oh, what goes first as it like breaks first? Mm. That I don't know. Next.
KK, have been using place while cooking in the kitchen. However, after a while, she'll go somewhere else to lay down, which is even further away. It doesn't bother me, but is this disobedience?
Well, it's not place. It's down somewhere. So place is on an object. And it's not about it being disobedient. It's about a dog not holding a command. So I'm glad the dog is learning to relax, but the dog did break command. How about if you were outside and you told your dog to lie down and all of a sudden it says, you know what? I think I'm going to move 10 feet over into the middle of the street. Or you're at like the beach, or you're at a park, or you're at a coffee shop and you tell your dog to lie down and your dog goes, you know what? I think I'm going to go 3 tables over. So command is command. Next.
$4.99 from Holden on Dog Training. Hell yeah, 2021 pool will be open. I'll let Hubs know it's date night. For those not taking advantage of Jeff's Patreon, you must join Zoom meeting Rock.
Oh, shoot, that's right. I will do a Zoom tomorrow at 3 p.m. Let me make sure. I don't know if it's any Skypes. Most likely, I don't think I do. Ooh. Yes, I do. 2 to 3. I'll still do one at 3 o'clock. So I'll do a 3 p.m. Zoom tomorrow in our Patreon channel. Next.
Gretchen, Muck Boot brand has boots on sale for like $20, I heard. Normally they're a good $100. Wow. Yeah, those things are expensive.
Wow.
I always hike in Muck Boots.
Those are really good. That's a really good price.
I'll have to go check that out. Hannah, now I'm working from home. My dog is whining for attention, but sleeps when not home at office. He's getting plenty of exercise and doesn't need to use the restroom. Suggestions?
What's the dog doing? Spinning?
Whining.
Whining?
Whining for attention.
Remote collar or bonk? Whining is an option historically. Whining is an option. Now, some dogs whine. He's trying to tell you something. Yeah, he's trying to tell you he's bored. He's trying to tell you he wants attention. He's trying to tell you something. Now, every once in a while, if it's, you know, the dog might have to go to the bathroom. But historically, the whining that we deal with is just bullshit whining.
Attention seeking.
Yes.
Levi, we're working on keeping our pack walks going, especially with the nicer weather. The whole idea of them is social distancing anyway, but still hard to get some people to come out.
Yes,
yeah.
It is. Good for you. Next.
KK, out of curiosity, have you noticed less water drinking being on a raw diet? Yes, my guys definitely drink less.
Probably less because the raw food definitely adds liquid, to them. I don't track it. I just fill up their bowls.
But you've been feeding it for so long. It's like usually once you first transition, it's
You notice it.
I was like paranoid in the beginning. I'm like, I should take them to the vet. They're dehydrated. They haven't touched their water in a whole day. Like I would normally be refilling it. Like
you get paranoid
constantly.
Really? No.
I know. Calm as a fucking cucumber all the time.
Overthink things. Next.
You're gonna get foopled tonight. Look it up in the dictionary. It's gonna be Jeff's face.
Right. We should probably have like our own little dictionary, like
a foople.
What a foople. Have a quiz.
We could do trivia.
We can do a quiz show. Mm-hmm. We should do a quiz show next.
Pulsar dog training.
And you know who would come up with probably the questions? Is the fans.
The fans.
They'll remember them better than us. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they'll remember them better than us.
Pulsar dog training. When I bonk one of the other dog's kennels for whining, our two Danes will bark and growl. How should I address this? Practice bonking random empty cage incorrect with remote?
Yes. Next.
KK, do you use flea and tick prevention? I never have, but vet is stressing it.
Well, vet will stress a lot of things. The vet will stress that your dog needs to use that brand new machine that they just bought. So, you know, it's like, we got that machine over there. We're paying $975 a month to lease the fucker. So we got to get some dogs into that machine. It's like, have you checked your puppy for glaucoma yet?
Oh, stop. So, you should use flea and tick, I think.
But I put the collars on them.
Seresto.
The Seresto collars.
KK, has anyone at the facility been bit by a client's dog?
Gotcha. Not in a long time. I used to get bit all the time when I first started dog training because I was working with dogs way outside my pay grade, and I was not taking the safety precautions that I should have. I was cocky as fuck, and I used to get bit bad. But it's been a long time since someone's been bit here. We get attempted bites. Mm-hmm. We deal with dangerous dogs. We deal with biting dogs. But we understand pressure. We understand thresholds. We know how to handle dogs, you know, really, really well. We've got good leash handling skills. We're hyper aware that we're dealing with dangerous dogs. So we've got to be, you know, I think the more experience you get, you know, it's the less attempts you even get of biting. Next.
Doshkal. Jeff, if you had the chance, would you ever go on the Joe Rogan Experience? You should.
If I ever had the chance, what I probably would do is I would ask if my daughter, Olivia, can go in my place because she's a knife maker and he probably would like that, but she's not interested in doing that at all because she's turned down.
Okay, but would you go on Joe Rogan?
Because she's turned down, like, what's that one show?
Forged with Fire.
They actually want her to be on that show.
Yeah.
Like, they've called.
I could so see her being like.
They've called her numerous times.
Yeah.
Like, numerous times.
She's so, like, anti that stuff.
She's so anti that stuff, yeah. So.
But would you?
Would I go? Yeah, sure, why not?
You like Joe Rogan?
Yeah, I love him. Yeah, I watch his interviews. Yep, I watch his interviews. Yep, I tend to watch his, I don't watch his MMA stuff. A lot of times when he has a comedian on,
how cool would that be?
I don't usually
Jeff
watch
Gellman
that
on the Joe Rogan
Experience. But when he has some like really interesting folks on, like Jordan Peterson interview,
I like that
Ben
one.
Shapiro interview. Yeah, when he has his intellectuals on, I like to watch that a lot. Next,
Jack, how long should a typical training session be for obedience? I want to work. Sorry, guys. Challenge my dog without overwhelming him.
Well. What happened?
Uh-oh. You're touching shit, and you shouldn't be.
I was trying to get you more in the camera, give you more some camera space. There you go. Actually, that light's showing. Let me move over a little bit this way. You move this way, and then we go like that. Yep. Okay. It's all up to you on how long you want to work your dog. You can do a 15-minute intensive session. You can do a 30-minute intensive session. You mix in some duration with it. You know, you can do fast obedience, slower obedience. You know, I don't know if there's an exact time. Next.
Ramsey, when a dog misbehaves and gets a timeout or punishment, how long would you do it for? If there is another dog in the house, should interaction be different with it while first dog is being punished?
Okay, so let me explain punishment to you. We don't do that. That's not what a punishment is. I don't do timeouts, and a punishment is 1 second. And then you carry on with life. There's no yelling. There's no screaming. There's no bad dog. There's no go in your crate. There's none of that. That is not what punishment is. Not in my world. Punishment is matter of fact. It's a intolerable consequence that lasts for 1 second, sometimes a little bit longer, but it becomes a non-event. It's just a matter of protocol. It's a matter of protocol. Okay, next.
Nathan, truck driver, dog guy again.
Hey.
My bull mastiff barks at stuff, people, vehicles, etc., yep. Which I like since we're alone frequently. How do I train? Is it okay to warn me about stuff, but then shut up and chill?
Yeah, so being an RV, I've got different rules. So if I'm in the vehicle driving, or if I'm in the vehicle at all, like during the daylight hours, no barking is not acceptable. We have 5 dogs in the RV. So Joelle brings 2 of her dogs. I bring 3 of my dogs. So we travel to seminars together. No barking allowed. If I'm out of the vehicle, say we're food shopping, or we're at a rest stop going to the bathroom or doing something like that, bark all you want. I want people to know there's a RV full of dogs.
Mm-hmm.
At night, it's tricky because we sleep in truck stops, and we don't sleep in the truck stop lanes. Don't worry about it. We keep out of the truck stop lanes. We sleep in the bus lanes, or we can take up 2 parking spots because I've got a Class C, which has got 12 feet from the rear wheel, so we can really finagle a lot of different spots. Or Walmart, or Home Depot, or hotel parking lots. So at night, we sometimes rest stops. So we sleep sometimes in some sketchy areas. So Kira gives out a very distinctive growl. This low growl, which means that there might be danger close. That I'll respond to historically. But if you want to have 1 or 2 warning barks and then tell your dog to be quiet and it's quiet, I have no problem with that either.
But how do you train it?
You train your dog how to shut up. So remote collar. So give it a command, quiet. Boom.
Exactly. That's the important part. I have to talk about it, is you need a marker.
Yeah.
So if you just correct barking instantaneously, the dog's going to be like, I can't ever bark.
Right, exactly.
But if you do a precursor to it, like enough, quiet, then correct, the dog will always wait for that cue to shut up.
Yeah, you need to say thank you. Thank you. Boom.
Yeah.
Like anything.
Next. Markers are important.
But something. Next.
Debbie, hi Jeff, how are you? Me and my little guy Lucas is doing great. Stay healthy. Debbie Eifler.
Awesome. It's Debbie. I'm doing my best to stay healthy and I'm doing fantastic. Next.
Pulsar dog training. When my dog tries to forge ahead, it's just barely. Like she's trying to hold heel, but she wants to get ahead so bad. Almost prancing next to me, taking an inch at a time. Hard to get a good 180.
So what your dog is doing is your dog is probably in a semi-aroused state and you want your dog to be more in follow mode, which is a whole different state of mind. So that's why we have dogs walk behind us. And we teach the dogs how to walk behind us with the spatial pressure move that I've got a free video on YouTube with. Next.
Sid, hi guys. I got a 1-year-old GSD yesterday working on recall in the house with leash. Pulls outside, jumps on me with the prong, mouths at the leash. I bonked for jumping. He's everywhere all at once.
Right. So you just got the dog yesterday. So let's be really methodical. Massive amounts of structure in the dog's life. Make sure the dog is kenneled up. Tons of structure. The jumping, you can get under control immediately. Pulling, you can get under control immediately. So by the next show, which is Wednesday, you'll have made progress. Next.
I can't believe it's still bright out at 7:30.
Yeah.
So great. Kathy, help for someone that wants their new dog to ignore the cat. Watched a few of your videos but need more info. I can teach my dogs, but they respect me. I know she needs more respect from her dog.
So talk to her about that. But you can also use a remote collar at a high level and then it'll ignore the cat. Make it suck to not ignore the cat and your cat problems go away. Historically. Next.
Linda, how do I know if she is getting overwhelmed and more stressed? I wonder if the correction level on the e-collar is too low. Should I go higher? When corrected, she only shakes her head and keeps barking.
So it's not a punishment then. You've not applied a punishment. The dog is still doing it. So go higher. Try that. And it doesn't matter what level. It's a level that shuts the dog up. But there's some dogs that don't give a shit about levels. They'll blow through a remote collar. So, yeah. Or they'll get corrected and then they'll bark at that and they'll get correct. So it's like it's nonstop. So you have to be, some dogs you have to be really creative with. Just, you know, just remember, you know, I feel confident with this show, answering the questions on the show with a wide paintbrush stroke, because 95% of the dogs out there respond really well to it. But there's always going to be some dogs that don't respond to this stuff. Even we have dogs here at our center that mm-hmm. the advice that I'm giving out doesn't work with. But 95% of the dogs that are out there, including here, do respond to that stuff. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that's why people are like, oh, you need to get to know the dog better. It's like, no, you don't. Now when it comes to stopping unwanted behaviors historically, but there are absolutely dogs that we have to be really creative with.
Yeah.
Extremely creative with, you know, extremely creative.
I'm just testing the waters to see if it hurts.
I know.
Linda, how do I?
And I'm advocating for you.
Thanks. You're welcome. Kathy, I can't stand to watch AFV when they show spinning shadow or light chasing. Not funny. It's horrible.
What's AFV?
America's Funniest Videos. Oh.
No, it's not funny at all.
Get with the times. AFV. Don't you know? I can't remember the last time I watched the show. I don't think I even, like,
okay.
ever did.
There's so many.
That's like I'm home from school sick and there's nothing else on. I guess I'll watch the show.
There's so many times I've mentioned.
Like eighth grade.
There's so many times I've mentioned something on this show, like a person, and you had no idea who they were.
I know. Or I'm a band. Busting your balls.
Okay, so. Next. But you're not, though.
Guys, wasn't it, though? Anyone from my generation, it's like, I'm homesick from school, and I have to watch, like, daytime television. AFV. Full House. You know?
Next.
Melissa posted the link to your Patreon channel for the Zoom tomorrow.
Thank you.
KK, thanks for the tip on the laser. Is it a laser pointer? And she does flip out over it, but it's gone now. What about our mini flirt pole, which she loves as well?
Flirt pole you can do. Flirt pole you can do. You start it, you finish it. And teach the out command. Next.
Gretchen, I got my foster dog adopted yesterday. Sent him off with his mini educator and prong. Thoroughly explained how to be a responsible owner and to communicate with him clearly. They listened really well.
Awesome.
We're initially against the e-collar and prong before we met and are now using it after I explained how it works.
Yep.
They corrected him this morning. I'm all for them owning the dog however they want. I just wanted to ensure they're going to be responsible.
Correct.
And not turn him into a fat, annoying brat.
Correct. Nobody wants that.
The cat? Was it a cattle dog too? Like definitely.
So this
don't
is this is
that.
The thing. Most people are against tools for one reason, because they think it hurts the dog. Makes sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I get it. I understand why you think a remote collar or a shock collar is bad, because you think you're hurting the dog.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I mean, I've like that's usually in the hate. It's like you do realize that if I yell at my dogs, they show more fear than if I use a remote collar.
Yep.
So my voice is a bigger punisher. We have a dog here that we use a squirt bottle on because we don't normally use squirt bottles. But that was the punisher that worked. Remote collar doesn't care.
Also, I'd like to touch on that. In public, it's socially acceptable. I've never once been questioned if I have to squirt that dog in public.
And it's so invasive.
It's so invasive. And people are just like, oh, he's in training. Right. No one has ever said shit. But if I remote collar stimmed him.
Yep. And you're literally like hunting down that dog, like spraying it.
Yeah.
Yeah. To get him to stop a certain behavior.
Yep.
Yep. But if you used a remote collar, you'd be the devil.
Yeah.
Yep. I know.
It's so incredible.
It's so weird.
Ramsey, how to get dogs to adjust to being alone when I go back to work after the shelter in place is over.
Yep.
I'm keeping my dogs in crates during the day now.
Yep, keep your dog in a crate during the day. Go outside, leave your dogs in the crate. Put your dog in the crate and leave the room. You need to be setting up your dog. We've talked about this a couple of times. I've done a live on it, but we need to make an official video on it about how not to create a separation anxiety dog when all of this is over,
mm-hmm.
because you're going to.
Yep.
Because people are getting puppies now, which is fine because you have plenty of time to train them. The problem is, though, you better start.
Put it in the crate and go outside at least.
Right. Treat the dog like you're after the after COVID situation, yes. or else you're going to have a shit show on your hands.
Literally.
Next.
Edwin, how do you correct whining in the crate with the e-collar? High-level tap or keep pressure on until it stops? She only does it when I leave to take my other dog and can hear her as I close the door. Thanks for your tips.
The answer is yes. So whenever anybody asks me about how to stop crate antics, do I use high levels, low levels, momentary or continuous? The answer is yes. What you do is set up a video camera and see what works. See what the magic formula is. Next.
Cheryl, Joel, Jeff talking about how he used to get bit in the start because he was cocky and training dogs over his pay grade would be an excellent short clip. Melissa picks them now.
Yeah. That one will get a lot of, like...
it's a conversation starter.
Conversation starter. Yeah.
Yeah, Gellman.
Yeah, Gellman. He still is cocky. Still has a big ego. He deserves to be bit. I wish he got bit more. Wish someone bit his voice box out so he couldn't talk. Wish someone bit his dick off because seven kids is enough. Don't worry, my fucking swimmers are so goddamn strong, we'd still fucking figure it out.
Oh my god, you're fucked.
Next.
Barista boy. Some multiple choice answers choices. Chancla, Senior Blanco, Aki, historically at PFS.
Yes.
I already forgot what freaking PFS is. We just said it in the show. What was it?
I have no idea. If you go back to the show.
What is it?
I don't know.
Hashtag PFS. What the hell?
You said that in tonight's show.
I just said it like 10 minutes ago.
I don't know. Pussy fart semen?
Something with fucking it, I think.
Next.
I'm crying. Levi. My brother has an 8-year-old boxer pit who is super reactive but friendly.
Wrong.
I'm sorry.
Can you have some sense of fucking professionalism on this show, please?
If she does something bad wrong, she'll go to her crate and thinks he can't correct her there because it's her safe place.
That's the biggest line of bullshit in the world. This concept that, so it's her safe place, so close the crate door. Don't let her go to her safe place. You can correct a dog in a crate. They're not going to associate the crate with something bad, especially if you mark it. Mark the bad behavior. Then no matter where the dog is, you can do it. I can't even fucking see you in the screen. But you get your hat with your hat down. I'm looking at a fucking headless horse over here.
I don't know why that was so funny. Okay. I can't remember what it was.
Okay, fine. Can we move on from that?
I'm trying. I'm really trying.
Okay.
Just do your thing.
Okay. This is lasting longer than most of your relationships. Well, come on. Let's keep going.
I don't have relationships.
Yeah, we know that.
Did you answer the question?
I don't even know what the question was. Did you ask a question?
Yeah, he can't get... His brother thinks he can't
correct his dog. Yes, I answered that question.
Okay, yes. Ryan. My 9-month-old Rottweiler sometimes lunges over to the other dogs on a walk. How can I stop this?
That's called... Yeah, that's bad. Make sure...
I'm not done yet. Oh. He wears a prong collar, too. But it doesn't bother him. Would the e-collar be a better option for this? Good evening from the UK, too.
Okay, hey, UK. So it's not about the prong collar. It's about the training. The prong collar is just a tool. So what I would do is, number one, he probably won't care about the remote collar either. Because these are just communication tools that have to have... The training philosophy behind it has to be in place. So what I would be doing is I would be correcting your dog for even looking at other dogs. There is a point prior to the lunge that the dog is loading. That's when the correction takes place. Once a dog is full in reactivity mode, you freaking better hold on for your life. That's all you can do. So you correct the dog prior to the lunging. Next.
Brandon, hello. My dog has very high energy drive and I exercise him almost every day I can. He's not satisfied. What are other ways I can stimulate him to keep him satisfied so I'm not walking him at 4 a.m.?
Okay. First of all, I own 3 high drive dogs. There's 5 high drive dogs in this room right now. They're all lying down. None of them are tired. They'll be lying down for, well, in this hour show. But if we did a 4-hour show, they'd be lying down for all 4 hours. They're all drivey dogs. So you need to spend more time on doing duration. I'm not saying don't exercise your dog. I'm a huge advocate of exercise. But what people do, you'll never be able to over-tire your dog. You're building yourself an athlete. Mm. The power of duration work is so huge. So place command, downstays, sitting in a chair. All right? And we've got free videos on all that stuff on our YouTube channel. Next.
That's a clip right there. That's a good one.
That's a clip.
You can't out-exercise behavior.
PFS. Pretty fucking simple.
Yeah, I was reading ahead.
Yes.
How did we forget that?
Because it's pretty fucking simple.
You forgot, too.
Of course I forgot.
Levi, I share your videos and links and encourage him to watch because he's wrong. If he knows she won't be corrected in the crate, she'll just go there and avoid punishment.
Right, exactly. It's like, bite a
kid. Because he's wrong.
It's like, bite a kid. Run in the crate.
Yeah.
Oh, can't correct him.
Right.
That's a safe place.
He's training the owner.
Yep.
That's funny, Levi. And encourage him to watch because he's wrong. That's brotherly love right there.
Yep.
Kathy, got you on cat. Thanks. Levi said, Jeff, you got me saying historically all the time now. LOL.
Nice.
Historically?
Historically.
Mothman, what's a good training timeline for a puppy? Obviously nothing major when they're 8 weeks old, but what about after that?
Well, when they're 8 weeks old, 8 to 10 weeks old, 8 to 12 weeks old, I mean, we're doing all marker and food training. We clicker train all the dogs. So you're doing all of that. They're not being corrected for any obedience whatsoever. So we're not being corrected for any obedience whatsoever. Are you gonna stop laughing?
This is just a good show.
Okay.
I'm like reading the comments ahead.
Stop doing that.
I love her fans.
All right. So it's all just obedience. All you're doing is obedience right now. And then also teach downtime, which people don't. They keep their puppies. They overtrain their puppies, and the puppies get exhausted. Next.
Kathy said, also, she contacted you. Yay.
Oh, cool.
KK, is it best to exercise the dog before the morning meal?
It doesn't matter to me. I have no formula about that. I can give a shit. So I've seen books that have said, exercise your dog first so they earn something. It's like, how about this? It's more convenient for me to fucking feed my dog first thing in the morning. So I feed my dogs at night, though. I feed them once a day, and I feed them at, like, today I think I fed them at 5 o'clock. Yesterday I think I fed them at 4 o'clock. You know, so it's like...
Mine are not on a set schedule.
Yeah.
Kathy, I already read that. Barista Boy, yes. And, well, the hosts of AFV are the most obnoxious. So true. Gretchen said he was mostly Aussie. Mark, and she has changed on a walk ever since I've got and used prong and e-collar. Walking, she's good, but anxious and whining when we see other dogs.
Yeah.
Any suggestions to help with the situation? Thanks. Yep.
You can use a remote collar for that. That's the shrapnel effect that's left over. So you can use a remote collar for that. It's like, I'm glad your walks are better, but that whining bullshit's got to stop. Next.
Levi laughed my ass off to while we would watch Price is Right and Maury Povich when we were home from school. I love the Maury show. I watched him too.
Maury Povich?
Yeah. I loved Maury.
Fuck.
I like the Price is Right
no
too.
No wonder you're fucked up. Now it all makes sense.
That's like literally what I grew up on.
Now it all makes sense.
And then at like 3 o'clock when you go home from school, it's like Ellen DeGeneres. You're like in the 6th grade watching the
For
Ellen
someone
show.
That doesn't watch TV.
We're talking in school.
I don't understand that.
What did you do? Come home from school and work on your side hustle at 11 years old?
Yeah. Of course I did.
Well, I didn't. I fucking ate potato chips.
Okay, fine.
And watched the Maury show. Well,
there you go. And there you have it.
And America's My City.
Next.
Kathy laughed my ass off at you needing to be bit more. I can't. Okay, Urban Canine Services. Ever use the Easy Educator? Thinking Dial may be easier than the Mini.
Yes, I have. I find the Dial harder.
I do too. I hit it with my thumb a lot
because it rotates. I don't want to say opposite, but it does rotate opposite than the Mini Educator. I'm not as comfortable with it. I like the other one.
The Dial, I feel like, is really sensitive too.
It
is. It's hard to get like a number.
Sometimes it skips in between numbers too.
Exactly. Levi said, "Laugh my ass off. This is a good episode." Hannah, pretty effing simple. PFS. Mark. Hi, J&J. My GSD gets really anxious when he sees dogs.
Can you stop? Why are you hitting me?
Because I can feel you, like, judging me?
I'm not judging you at all. When have I ever judged you?
Okay. Mark.
All right.
Hi, J&J. Why do you think it's really anxious when he sees dogs?
You don't have to speed up the question so you get through it before you laugh. You were talking at normal pace.
After dog went for her, she gets all anxious and whining. Any suggestions to help me? I just want to walk her past dogs as if it's not there.
So what I want you to do is this. Start utilizing a little bit of space if you want to. If your dog moves a little bit back behind you, you can do that as well. All right? Do you want me to keep answering the question just so you can take a laugh break? Or should we take a laugh break right now?
It's like when you're in school and you know you're not. Shit's just funnier. I'm sorry.
Do you want me to make a cup of coffee and you can just sit here and laugh? We'll just zoom the camera in on you.
Michael, my GSD stopped eating because of your laugh. He liked it or hated it. I like to say like it.
He's probably to throw up next.
Ashley, I would stay home and play sick from school. And watch Maury. See? It's not just me.
And you're not just laughing, you're laughing out of frame. Like, you keep moving over with your laugh.
I'm crying. Pack leader dog training. I love how Jeff will be responding to the questions. And I'm just watching Joelle's face trying to hold their laugh.
When is she... who is that? Pack leader dog training. At what point has she tried to hold her laughing in?
I'm literally crying.
She hasn't tried at all. If she has been trying, it's the most half-assed try I've ever seen. It's blatant laugh. There's been no trying to hold anything back tonight.
Oh, my God. It hurts. It hurts so bad. It's like an ab workout.
And then you're punching me, too. It's like, what the fuck?
Because I can feel your facial expressions. Like, I know what you look like. And you're, like, clearing your throat, like, anytime now. Urban Canine Services. Okay, awesome. Thanks. We'll have to try the mini. Levi, whatever edibles or weed you have, Joelle, I need some.
No.
No.
Nope.
I don't even drink.
Nope. Joelle doesn't do drugs or drink.
I'm just sleep deprived. Mercedes. Oh, hold on. There's more. Gretchen, Joelle's laugh is just priceless. Put that up on Spotify.
Yes.
Mercedes, do you have a video on teaching dogs existence with each other?
Yes. Do we have a video on that?
I mean, all of our socialization, but we're not... Really, right, giving you right. Step by step.
No, but I mean, start getting them to do place next to each other. That'll help next.
Terry, Jeff, Joelle has the best laugh.
I know.
You guys are fantastic.
I know. I'm just busting your balls. She can do a whole laugh track. I let her laugh.
What even started this? I don't even know.
7 o'clock rolled around.
Gretchen, Jeff being annoyed at Joelle's laugh makes it so much funnier. Right? I feel like when you're in school and it's like you're trying not to get in trouble and the teacher's just like pissed off and you're just laughing because like you're trying not to laugh.
Yeah, but I'm not getting pissed off.
I know, but that's like the situation. It's like you just keep laughing because you're trying not to laugh. You know?
I guess so.
Anyway, I mean, we're out of questions right now.
Are we really?
So see?
So, tomorrow we got a Zoom. If you don't know what Zoom is face-to-face what we're doing now. So I actually would see you talking and we can go back and forth, which is really, really nice. Seminars are going to be, you know, picking up again once we're back on the road. That's really, really exciting because we help a lot of people. We're still doing board and trains here. We're not doing one-on-ones. We got a one-on-one inquiry today for a 10-week-old puppy. But I'm not comfortable doing a one-on-one.
I'll do it.
Even with all this? Want to?
10-week-old puppy? Sure.
Okay. I don't know if I just want someone coming in every week.
True.
That's what I mean. Normally we do one-on-ones. I just don't know if I want.
You can do it outside in the parking lot. Puppies, if you have food, they'll stay engaged.
Just keep a long line on them. Could. It's a good idea.
Once the weather gets a little bit nicer anyway.
Yeah, I know. Next.
Let's see, Kathy, or no, Urban Canine Dog Services. Thanks for the laughs, massive chocolate cravings. Oh, and the dog training tips.
Yes.
Pack Leader Dog Training said the PFS started it. Yeah, because we couldn't remember what the hell it was. Gretchen, it's so much funnier when the teacher doesn't like it. Anna, I have 2 young dogs that constantly play in the evenings. I want them to stop, and it makes my husband anxious. I'm new to the idea of e-collars. Is this something that they'd be appropriate for?
No, just teach them place. Just literally teach them place to go to place and stay there. Next.
Barista Boy Soccer. Joelle, you were laughing, and then in a monotone voice, you just said, "Don't worry, no weed. I'm just sleep deprived."
You sure way to get that serious statement in.
Very serious.
Right.
Gretchen said, "Everything is funnier when people tell you to stop."
Right.
It's so true. Landon, best way to stop puppy biting?
I like to just take my thumb, put it in the dog's mouth, push down, and hold onto their lower jaw and just keep it there for a while until they become very, very uncomfortable. Next.
Landon, best, I just read that, Jesus. AL, leash dragging okay for recalling on e-collar?
Absolutely, 100%, but also teach the recall first. This concept that you would just correct a dog for not coming back to you without teaching it how to come back to you on the remote is wrong. Teach the dog how to come back to you first. Next.
Hannah, my dog is weary of strangers. Any suggestions to help get over this fear?
So, I mean, what I want you to do is just be around lots, exist around lots of people. Just exist around lots of people. That's it. And don't have them interact with the puppy, with the dog. Because that's what makes it worse. That's what makes it worse. Next.
Gretchen, thoughts on putting a harness on a puppy? Puppies are too young for prong or formal training anyway, so it wouldn't really matter for the time being, right?
Exactly. You could absolutely use a harness on a puppy. Next.
Jason, can I still correct my anxious dog if he has already exploded to another dog, or do I have to move away and try again?
Both. Both. You can correct the dog, but it's more effective if you correct the dog prior to the explosion. Next.
Jay, just got back from a 5-mile trail walk with dog off leash. The freedom of recall is great.
Awesome. Wow, 5 miles. That's pretty good. Good for you. Yeah, that means your dog probably went 15 miles because they go like up back and back forth. And to the side and, you know, everywhere, especially off leash. Next.
Levi, we push down on our puppy's tongue and he'll pull his head back like he's uncomfortable, but he'll continue. Suggestions? Levi's wife.
Bonk the dog. Use a bonker. Say no and then bonk. No and then bonk. That's what you're going to do.
That's it right now.
Great. I love how Levi's wife doesn't have a name.
It's Levi's wife. I know.
He probably made her write that. Like, you're not allowed to have an identity. I'm the only one that's allowed.
Levi?
What are you hitting me for? He's the one that did it.
He doesn't strike me as that kind of person.
No, I don't know.
What's your wife's name?
Mrs. Levi, probably.
I am Mrs. Levi.
Mrs. Levi.
Show yourself. What's your name? Linda, hello from Sweden. Thanks for your videos, guys. I was scared to correct my dog, but she's doing better now.
Awesome.
AL, awesome. With e-call or recall, should I back up as they approach me?
You can if you want to. You can. But I mean, ideally, in the training stage, you can. But we usually stand still. Next.
Gretchen, how long do you hold on to a puppy's tongue for that correction?
Until it stops. Until it becomes really uncomfortable for the dog. I don't know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 seconds maybe. Next.
Levi said, it's Senna. Oh, yeah, she was on, the last show under her own YouTube name.
Yep. She was on a Skype with us, too.
Terry, but Jeff, you're so close. Slap. Slap ya.
Next.
Gretchen, okay, Jeff gets annoyed at Joelle laughing and then cracks jokes that says Joelle laughing again. Senna, it's Mrs. Levi.
So, this is the thing. I don't get annoyed with...
It's Mrs. Levi.
So I don't get annoyed with Joelle's laughing. I honestly don't. Because I know it'll make a good clip, and I like to see her having fun, and I actually love her laugh. But I don't get annoyed at all. So my annoyance is fake annoyance. It's like podcast annoyance.
Different levels.
Yeah, but I don't get annoyed. There's nothing really about Joelle that annoys me. Nope. We've learned how to coexist. So, pretty well. Pretty well.
I think I annoy you when I make you do leg day at the gym.
I did leg day today before you got up.
Before I got up, yeah. So, I couldn't freaking see what you were doing in there.
Hey, I did that new exercise you showed me last time.
Doing the freaking bend and snap from freaking that one movie.
No.
What'd you do?
I did that leg exercise that you showed me last time.
Oh, RDLs?
Yeah, I did that with weight, with a kettlebell.
Okay.
With an arm out. Didn't even have to hold on to the pole. Did an arm out that way, bent down, leg back, this left knee bent. I did it. Cool. Yeah, damn right, it's cool. Okay.
Kathy, this is definitely a so much more show. Gretchen says, it's pleasant annoyance. Joelle isn't annoying at all. She's the best.
No, she's not annoying at all.
Oh, Gretchen, you're so sweet. Edwin, what time do you do the Zoom sessions,
Jeff? It looks like 3 o'clock. So it looks like 3 p.m. probably on Tuesdays and Thursdays I'll be doing them.
You're going to go straight from a Skype into a Zoom. You should maybe make it for like 3:15.
Okay.
You're probably going to have to make a coffee.
Okay. So it's at 3 o'clock, guys. Next.
Okay.
Thanks for the suggestion.
On that note.
On that note.
We got like 45 seconds left. Any last minute questions?
Last minute questions. But at the end of the show, we're going to tune off. We have to do last call for dogs. It's our night.
Got to wash my hair.
This week it's Monday. Well, that's, you're doing that on your own. But we have to do what last call? Cool. More Airbnb nonsense in Florida.
Yeah, I just paused the show.
Yep. I know.
Urban Dog Services has leg day tomorrow. Nice.
All right, guys. We're gonna log off and rotate dogs and potty them and take off all their equipment and put them to sleep. All right?
Good night.
Good night, everybody. Take care.
Thanks for putting up with my nonsense, everyone.
Yep. Love you all.